Yo, what's up, people? It's your boy. I'm Chris the Dom One, and I am back with another video. Now, Complex, the YouTube channel, has a show, and this show is piping hot. It's called Everyday Struggle. Now, for those out there who's been living under a rock and really doesn't know the nuances of Everyday Struggle, basically, Everyday Struggle, to me, in my opinion, is pretty much set up like ESPN First Take, okay? The two stars of that particular show is Joe Budden and DJ Akedemiks, and they come from two different worlds and two different universes, talking about the hip-hop culture, the hip-hop industry, social media events that are related to the struggle and the grind of hip-hop, okay? Now, Joe Budden is a former rapper. He had several hits back in the day. So his aspect of, he understands the music industry. He understands how labels work. He also understands what's a true definition of an album being a success or being a flop, things of that nature. Now, DJ Akedemiks, on the other hand, he comes from the experience from the YouTube community, that particular culture. Now, some say this about DJ Akedemiks. Now, I don't necessarily agree with this, that DJ Akedemiks, when you look at his content on his particular channel, he comes off as sometimes being a little arrogant, sometimes he's acting like a troll, and on certain serious topics, sometimes he will spin and use comedic aspects to the things that he is talking about, particularly about Chirac, about a lot of rappers beefing in Chi-Town. A lot of people have lost their lives in that region. And if you look at some of the material DJ Akedemiks has on his YouTube channel, some are under the impression that they have an axe to grind with DJ Akedemiks on how he displays the message that's what's going on in these ghettos, okay? Basically saying that, you know, it's okay to troll about it. It's okay to be funny about it because he lives that life. And from what I gathered and what I read from DJ Akedemiks, I really don't see the correlation there, okay? But that's neither here nor there. Now, a particular guest he had on today's show was a rapper from that particular region. His name is Vince. I forgot his last name. And he had some choice words about DJ Akedemiks, okay? Basically, he said he wanted to slap DJ Akedemiks in the mouth because of the material that he has on his YouTube channel. And his material comes off being very funny, very comedic on issues that are not that funny. They are really serious about people that are dying in these inner city ghettos, most notably Chicago, okay? Now, DJ Akedemiks tried to defend himself by stating this, what everybody is talking about. Yes, everyone is talking about it, but from what Vince was saying, who gave you the right, who gave you the authority and the opinion to not only talk about this, but try to make light of it, okay? To try to make it, to try to make these incidents relevant to you. That's basically what I gathered from this show. Now, he told DJ Akedemiks he wanted to slap him. He called DJ Akedemiks a lame. He called him a lot of choice words that I'm not going to say on my channel, okay? You can go check out the video for yourself, Everyday Struggle on Complex Magazine. Here's the bottom line. I think everyone should take a page from this particular incident, okay? You don't necessarily have the right. You have to be careful on what you say when you're talking about certain topics and certain issues that may conflict and may have huge implications on the areas or certain people, okay? If it's a serious, touchy topic, then you should address it that way. You shouldn't necessarily address it being a little arrogant, trying to add a comedy to it. Sometimes the things that, particularly in Chi-Town, a lot of people are dying over there. And if you don't know what's going on, it's okay to report the story. But it's another thing to add your own opinion and add your spin and come off sometime. And maybe your communication will probably come off to these people as a person that is being very funny, very comedic on something that is really not that funny. Okay. It's not that comedic to them because they may have loved ones or they may know of people that have died because of that. Okay. And that's what he was pretty much illustrating, the Vince guy, he was illustrating to DJ Akedemiks, like, none of this stuff is funny, dog. This is what they go through on a day-to-day basis. He has gone through tons of funerals to, you know, this is a very serious matter that's going on in his region, okay? And DJ Akedemiks, as well as everyone, you know, we have learned. I mean, even though DJ Akedemiks didn't admit it, on that particular show, he learned that sometimes it's okay to report things from your perspective. It's okay to have an opinion about certain issues that may or may not reflect your lifestyle and your well-being. But it's another thing to sometimes go over and sometimes you may say something and somebody might twist your words around. You may not mean what you're saying. And also being funny and comedic on very touchy and serious topics, that's a line that a lot of people get tripped up on, okay? So be careful, you know, on what you're saying. Basically, respect the people that you're talking about. Respect these individuals like they actually live next door to you, like you actually have a connection to them. Be very serious to the causes and don't try to make light of something, be funny of something or troll something, because sometimes, like it or not, when you deal with these people one-on-one, 1v1, like you did today, DJ Akedemiks, you start to look like a total jerk and a total ass, and you really couldn't necessarily defend yourself. Now, you try to use the excuse, well, everybody's talking about this, which is true. Everybody is talking about this, but the one thing that separates maybe you from the other people that are talking about this, and maybe these people are not using the same type of material you're using when you're talking about this, is trying to be funny on a serious topic. Sometimes that never pans out in a good way, okay? Like 3 weeks ago, Bill Murray, whatever his name is, he tried to be funny and comedic by using the N-word, and now a lot of people were at his neck and at his throat for using that word. But, you know, as a comedian, he's trying to make light on a subject that they was talking about in that recent show. And sometimes when you make light of something that is real serious, or if you try to say something and someone gets the impression that you're trying to troll them, you're trying to do this, you're trying to do that, it gets you into further deep water and deep trouble. Now, with Bill Murray, he didn't necessarily have to deal with an African-American when he used the N-word. He can pretty much go in hiding on social media and really not address it on social media. He did, like 8 hours later, apologize, okay? But when you're talking about DJ Akedemiks, I see a lot of his content, and I could understand why people feel a certain type of way when he uploads a video. Now, I'm not excusing DJ Akedemiks on what I'm about to say, but I could understand the method of the madness that he was using. He was trying to be very entertaining and, you know, deliver the message without the subscriber base or the people who are viewing his video get bored midway through and stop watching it, okay? So I understand why he was trying to add a touch of flair to it, but on certain things, when you're talking about death or someone's threatening someone's life, or, you know, someone happened to die, issues like that, there's no way around it. You just have to come forward, deliver the news, and pretty much that's it. You know, as far if you want to add some opinions, make sure your opinions are respectable. Make sure that the things that you're saying is not going to come across as an individual that is, you know, arrogant or really doesn't know what's really going on or trying to be very comedic. So everyone should learn from this lesson. I'm pretty sure from here on out, DJ Akedemiks is going to change how he does things on his YouTube channel. And, you know, I'm thinking, you know, DJ Akedemiks, when he was making these videos, he was thinking, yo, I'm doing them in my basement, in my attic. You know, I'm, you know, trying to be a little funny on a very serious subject. I'm not going to meet these people on the real, okay? And when you get these jobs like Everyday Struggle, it's a very popular job. It's a very political job. And it's a job that those people that you was trolling and you was pretty much guarded from their, you know, from their actions, from your computer. When you're having a show like Everyday Struggle, you can't hide from these people, okay? But I do feel like Complex Magazine, they should, if you know, they should understand what direction or what path they're going to do with Everyday Struggle. If they're going to try to continue bashing artists or bashing record labels or CEOs, if they want to go into that lane, then I don't understand how you're going to have guests appearing on these shows. And the guests that are appearing on these shows, they have an agenda with your host, okay? And yes, good or bad publicity is still publicity, but sometimes it's going to take a show where you're going to have somebody on that show and they're mad, and they're really mad at your host, and an altercation is going to come out of this. And yes, you're going to get the ratings, you're going to get the views, but somebody's going to be embarrassed, and 9 times out of 10 is going to be the host. And now you have to restructure this whole thing, or the one of the hosts decides to leave, okay? So it is what it is. But guys, tell me what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe. Please, notification gang, hit that notification icon, that notification bell. It will let you know. It will inform you when my next live stream or video is going down. It's your boy. I'm Chris the Don One, and I am out.